Well, guys, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but we lost it. The first Anno 1800 challenge, we came in second place, and that, to me, is the first place loser. So today, Ubisoft has sent us another package, and we have another challenge to do. I don't know what's in store, so we're gonna read it right now and see what's inside. But before we open that, I do want to thank Ubisoft once again for sponsoring another video. I don't know anything about this challenge yet, so we're gonna read that. But if you guys are curious about Anno 1800, it is now fully released. Link will be in the description where you can go and pick it up if you are curious as you're watching me play. So, no idea what the challenge is. Hopefully it's not getting 10,000 population again, because we were pretty good at that. But Blitztopia, I mean, he got it in like 30 minutes. I did 50. I feel pretty good about that, but clearly not good enough. So I'm coming for you, Blitztopia. Today, we're gonna win it. Dear Dre, unfortunately, you were not able to claim the victory in the first Anno 1800 challenge. Basically what I just said. The good news is you have a second chance to compete and reign supreme. Can you make a comeback and win the final challenge, or will you falter under the pressure? I don't like this pressure. What do we win this time? That's what I want to know. What you guys get out of this? Your mission, it's a race to be the first to set foot in the new world. So we're definitely going to be doing some sailing today and going deeper into what Anno's all about. Should you win this second challenge, one of your viewers who replies to the tweet in the description of this video with the hashtag Anno1800 will win a custom-built Intel PC and a copy of Anno1800. Your viewers believe in you, don't let them down. And I'm gonna give it my best shot. I really do want you guys to win. I love this challenge, so I feel like we might do a good job at this one. You have 3 hours to complete this challenge starting now. Good luck. So here we go again. Another Anno1800 challenge and another chance for you guys to win an Intel PC. I failed you last time. Hopefully this time I have what it takes to win it. Now, if you did miss the last episode though, I do recommend you go check it out. It was actually a really cool challenge where we had to get to 10,000 residents, like I said. Link will be in the description for that video as well. But we got another challenge to do, so let's get out there, play some more Anno 1800, and set sail. All right, so another day and another Anno challenge, and the pressure is on once again for me to be successful this time. Last time we came in second place, and that's pretty damn good. But none of you guys, unfortunately, got a PC out of that, and I do truly want to get you guys one, so we're going to try our best today. So, new task, we have to make it to the new world. We're going to start a new game for that. Sandbox mode, just like last time. Less guidance, please, because we can't waste any time. And I'm going to pick the same avatar, because he did a pretty damn good job last time. Now, last time, we were the pirates, and I think this time, being that we are going to be exploring the seas, I don't really want to advertise myself as a pirate, so we're going to go with the old tree. And once again, we will be Drayvon Gast. And if you do see this character or this name in the game with a character, that is indeed myself. And if you could tweet me it, that would be great, because I have still not seen me in this game and I really want to see it. All right, and once again, we're going to do a normal game. And let's start the time. I mean, technically, I think we're supposed to start at when we load in. I'm going to start it right now, though, and hopefully I don't regret that with the 3 seconds that we lost. Okay, so here's our starting island. What do we got working with this time? Wow, a much bigger island than last time. I was watching Blitz's play, and he had such a large island. I was so jealous. So the one we had was a little bit of a struggle. Anyways, let's waste no time. Let's get on it here and start building. So what I'm going to do, first of all, is get timber. That's something we are going to need a lot of. So let's get that out and started right away. We're going to do 2 timber yards here. And we want to make sure they're 100% or close to. There we go. That is good. And we'll connect the road to those. So last time we really focused on the farmers. That's all we actually did. This time we're not going to try and expand out as quickly as the last time. We definitely don't want to do that. That's a quick way to ruin a whole nation. But just for what we are trying to do, it worked really, really well. This time though, what's going on here? What's wrong? Okay, so it's just missing the wood because the insufficient workforce that I hopefully have changed with the placement of all these homes. We didn't have homes before. But yes, now we have to work. The main focus of what we want to do today is make their needs met. That way we can upgrade them to move on. We have to get to, I believe, the artisans to actually voyage to the new lands. That's the whole goal right now. So basically right now we're working on trying to make these guys as happy as possible. How we're going to do that is with a fishery. We still need a few more farmers to do that though. So what I'm going to do is put one more line of farmers down. And I actually don't have the timber to do that just yet, so we're just going to have to slow it down a little bit. Oh, that's right. I'm not speeding up either. Okay, so I lost a little bit of time there. Hopefully, we don't regret that at the end. Okay, so their fish need is pretty much met. New thing has been unlocked. Work clothes is what they really want. So
With that in mind, we are going to build some farmlands. I think we're actually going to build farmlands. Well, we got the timber mills over here, so I'm thinking actually farmlands can go. We'll build another road down here, and we will start building on this road all of our farmlands. So we need some wool. Let's get some sheep down, and we'll do a little square. I like the squares because it's easy to deal with when you're trying to place other things around them. And we'll put the frame workers on the other side. And just for safe measures, we'll throw another warehouse here. Now, we learned last time that we definitely want a fire station up early, so we'll try and get that up as quickly as possible. But we're well on our way here. We can probably, once we get these clothings in, we should be able to upgrade some of these guys to the worker faction, which is what we're going to be dealing with next. And here comes the clothes, and it looks like they're happy enough already, so immediately we're going to move on to the worker faction. I'm trying to get up these factions as quickly as possible. We will put down some safety nets like the firehouse, but there's a lot of things we're going to be skipping just to try and get to the new world as quickly as possible. So now, as you can see, we've upgraded that home. They are workers now instead of the farmers that they were before. So now we have this new tab. Whoops, that was the wrong button. And this is all the things that the workers can obtain. So what they need right now, they want some delicious sausages. So let's get them some sausages. We need a pig farm for that and a slaughterhouse. So once again, we're going to upgrade our farming here. And we are going to need more workers to deal with this. So we will check out that in a second and deal with the amount of workers that we need. We're actually okay right now. We're at a plus for both of them, so that's good. We don't want to overexpand if we don't need to. Okay, bricklaying would be smart. Do we have bricks on this world? Please tell me we do. Clay deposits are here. We just got to find them right now. So where? Oh, where? There's one here. I'd like one a little bit closer. There's one there. Oh, perfect. Look at this. Right over here. I didn't even see it. We do have a clay deposit. So we're going to build over to that. And we're going to put a brick factory right by that. And I know bricks are pretty slow in this game. So we'll put a warehouse here. And we will increase the working conditions here. I know we got a skeletal team right now. Let's actually deal with that first. Make sure our workers are happy. We don't want people to revolt because I don't got time for them to revolt. So we're going to upgrade all these. We have some timber in the bank. We do have 33 timber, so that's good. So let's put down some more farmers' residences, and we're just going to connect to this, and we'll slowly upgrade the old farmers to the new workers. Okay, it looks like most of these households are happy. What are we missing? Oh, we don't have the upgrades. So I'm thinking maybe we should do another timber mill, because I thought two would be enough, but clearly that is not the case. What's going on here? No warehouse in range. What? Excuse me, it's right beside you, dude. Is there not a road? There isn't a road here. How did I do that? Okay, there we go. You guys should be good now. It's a good thing we noticed that, or they wouldn't have been doing anything for a while. Have another workforce shortage. That's fine. We need the bricks right now, though, for the slaughtering house. So just to not get these shortages, let's get an influx of workers here. And we'll just put down some more farm homes if we lose all of our farmers doing this. I really wish you could, like, drag and upgrade all of these. It doesn't look like you can do that in any way. So that's one thing I would like to see later. All right, but there we go. We're plus 50 and plus 65. We should have a pretty happy civilization right now. So like I said, lumber is very important. Let's get another one down here. This one's only at 85%. Okay, so we really got to spread these things out. You know what? I'm going to put it down here, and we'll just build a road that goes to it. But yeah, the more lumber we get, the faster we can expand. So very important to get lumber at all times. Also, can we upgrade the warehouses now? I believe... No, we can't upgrade them yet. We can. We just need bricks. So yeah, bricks are of utmost importance right now. You know what? Let's actually trade for bricks as well. This is something that you really should use in this game if you have the money to do so. So we are going to purchase bricks. I'm also going to prep ahead of time and purchase some steel because I know we're going to need some to move on to the new world. So we should hopefully be able to get to steel work, but if we don't, at least we can purchase it. And use that to travel to new worlds. And editor time! Okay, so once again, we're going to edit this. We don't want them to know that I'm in the negative right now, so we're going to hypnotize them with happiness, because I have been overworking them a little bit, so that should be good. We're actually in the positive right now, amazingly. Oh, hey, what's going on here? Take photo. What do you want me to take photo of? Oh, crap, I should have looked at that. A photo of fighters. I don't see any people. Oh, are these people fighting? No, you know what? I don't have time for this, man. I'm not really sure. There must be people fighting somewhere, but I'm not really sure where. All right, if I didn't have a PC on the line, I would try and help you guys, but I got other things to do, so we're gonna keep going. So we need bread right now, which we should have unlocked in the workers tab. Let's get that going, and we're also gonna need soap. So first of all, bread should be easy. We just need farmers' fields, and we got lots of room for that. So we're gonna put some wheat over here. Oh, great, a fire. Oh, wait. Where? I'm assuming over here. Where? Okay, hold on. Where's the fire at? Explosives. Oh my god, it exploded. Okay, so it wasn't a fire. It just totally destroyed everything. All right, well, you know what? Do I have a fire station? I'm pretty sure I put a fire station down. Yeah, one right over there. So at least we got one we can move around. I don't think we're going to need more than one. Now that set us back, though. We got to wait for the bricks to repair this. And we still got to wait for the bricks for the other thing as well. No warehouse in range. What are you talking about? Oh, I didn't notice I didn't connect to it. Oh, man. Okay, so that was a little bit of a mistake. Now, hopefully, we're getting more bricks. Okay, we really need to get this steel as quickly as possible. Trades are not coming in, so I'm at a standstill pretty much until I get my steel sorted. And there we go. We should have everything made to start making steel. Because we're going to need steel to make the soap, oddly enough. And these guys are waiting on the soap still. And the one other thing they need is a school. We need a lot more workers for that. So we're going to have to do some rapid expansion here, I think. Oops, I just realized I made a mistake. All right, but there we go. That's looking good. And we're going to continue building the homes over here. This seems to be working well. It's a rather small area. I should have built it in a bigger area probably, but we should be okay, more or less. Oh, what's going on today? How we... Oh, that is not good, guys. That is not good. We are going to edit the as much as we can on this. Yes, I can. Yes, I can. We're going to publish that bad boy. Hopefully the propaganda doesn't hit us in the butt late later on, because bad things can indeed happen, obviously. All right, and the happiness will be a thing that we have to worry about, probably. So we're going to put a pub down just in case. I'm not going to focus too much on happiness, but we do want to make sure our dudes are happy. So now that they have that, are we good? Yes, we are. Okay, so that is good. You have to cater to everybody. So these guys are a little bit more unhappy for some reason. Their happiness. They do have the pub, so it's not that that's really affecting them. It looks like it's just a shortage of these clothing. Okay, and there we go. We've addressed their issues, and they seem to be pretty content here, so that's good. And how are we doing over here for these guys? Lots of bread and everything. Clothing seems to be good. So they're overall pretty damn happy. Luxury. They don't have any luxuries, so they want things like churches. Let's get them the churches that they need. I think it's right in here. Yeah, there we go. We'll throw a church down. Hopefully that should help these guys so we can move on to the next part. We still got to get that soap down. Okay, I was too busy working on other things. Where's that soap factory? Can we finally do it? Yes, we can. All right, so now we're producing soap. That should hopefully be enough to push these over to artisans, which is what we need next. We do need that school, though. How close are we to that? We are much closer now. Let's get some more workers. Let's just make some of these guys workers, and we should be able to get that right now. There we go. New buildings have been unlocked, and that is a school. All right, so that's good. We got that here. What are we missing with this one? 25 and 20? Jesus. Okay, that's going to take a little while, but that will make these guys happy and probably enough to push them over to the next area once this soap comes in, of course. Hopefully we're producing enough soap. What we're missing right now is schnapps. It's something I totally skipped. I might be regretting that. Hopefully not. I don't think we're going to need it. Actually, do I have a soap factory? I thought that was the soap factory. I don't think that was. So this is a three-part process, and that's why. Okay, that makes sense. So this is the rendering works, and that goes to the soap factory. So did waste some time there, too, admittedly. Hopefully we don't regret that. But now, officially, we're making soap. So please tell me that's what we need. You guys have a school, so maybe it's too far away. Let's throw another school down here. That should hopefully make these guys really, really happy. You can see it's not going up. Oh, that's right, because we don't... Oh, I'm smart. I forgot we're missing the materials. We're close, though. Real close. We just need a few bricks, and I think I'll actually use this school instead. It's more in the middle of these guys. Oh, God, another one? How are we doing this time? Oh, hey, okay, okay. You know what? Let's just publish that. I'm not going to deal with propaganda if I don't need to. And we are ready for a school. There we go. That was a lot of money. Oh, man, we're really close. Now we got the soap. I think we should be... We got a little bit of schnapps. Maybe we should get some more schnapps. What are we missing? Oh, it's just my cost. I just need... Look at that! We have the artisans! Okay, fine craftsmanship is here. Okay. I am rushing so much just because I want to do this. So now we should be able to do expeditions. And this is what we want to do. So we have to find the new world. So we're going to assign a ship. We only have one ship right now. It's got some weird cargo right now. So we're going to actually get rid of this. Hopefully we got some food in here that we can take with them. Keep the timber, I guess. It's not letting me get rid of it.
An explosion in one of your factories.
Oh, great. Explosions. Fun. All right, so we got a little bit of sausage.
Game save.
Oh, man. I don't know if we're going to have enough food here. But we're going to give them the bread and sausage, and hopefully that gives them 89% moral. Hopefully that's enough. I know we can use the sausage to help with the moral as well, or any food, mind you. So let's, being that we have a lot going on right now, let's just start this expedition. And hopefully with 89% moral, they will find the new world. So what is going on here? We had a fire going on. Like, three things happen the moment I look away. That's the crazy thing. Okay, it's put out. Thank God it's put out. Holy crap, though. Like, seriously? Ah, never a dull moment in Anno, man. Wait, sorry, informs me about a problem loading the ship. We're not even left yet. Okay, looks like it was good. I don't know what problems it was with loading it, but it's gone now. That was a little bit of wasted time. Hopefully we're good. So now, if we have a lucky expedition, we should find the new world, and then we just have to set sail over there. So, oh man, I really hope we're ready to go. I did do some research. I know that we need 10 timber and 8 steel. So... Please. We're okay for that right now. Princess Quing is introducing herself, so that's nice of her. I haven't built any trade deals or anything, just because I haven't had time. All right, so the artisans are here. I'm not going to expand out too much to the artisans because I don't want them upset with me. I want people to be happy so we're profitable. We got to keep this money in the bank so we can use it to expand out later. You know what we could do, though?
To get back to the blue.
All right, so the expedition is underway officially now. They have left the map, so yeah, we are... looking for a new world, but we can work on doing like a shipyard here. What else can we put down here? Depot, harbor master's office. We haven't earned anything yet, so that wouldn't make sense. Mounted guns, cannon towers. So there is defense in this too, which is really cool. I guess the one thing that would make sense is the sailing shipyard. That way we could prep a ship for when we're ready to go. Now we don't have the resources for that just yet. We need, once again, bricks, but we should get that soon. Actually, real soon, as in right now. So now we can build a ship as we wait. And look at that, a frigate is actually here and ready to go. We don't actually have the resources. I'm not sure why these other ones are grayed out though. So we need, it looks like, a few steel. Oh, we need a sailmaker as well. So let's get that done. We're already getting the thread that we need, so we should be able to do it with just this. And once again, waiting on the bricks.
We have the devil to pay.
We have the devil to pay. Engagement. Unfair imprisonment. While enjoying some well-deserved shore leave, a local militia seizes a dozen members of your expedition without explanation. They are taken to a fortress that's been hollowed into sandstone cliffs that dominate the harbor. The charges against your crew prove spurious to spurious? Okay, I am not the smartest guy in the ship, I will say that, to say the least. And when a hefty sum is demanded in exchange for their release, the militia's intentions become all too plain. Success chance 20% if I try and break them out. That is not high enough. I'm just gonna pay it. Hopefully, we got some timber here. Oh, you guys want a lot, don't you? Oh, man. Already we're being attacked. I came with a very few amount of items, so... this might be what I'm regretting here. Actually, we don't have enough. We do not have enough to do this, so I am going to cancel that. No fine, no prisoners. The militia make it clear. Your crew members will not be freed unless their ludicrous demands are met. Man, if I leave without my sailors, though, you know what? We're going to try it here. 20%. You secure an early release. Your men are returned to the ship. Talk about lucky. Okay, so we got it with a 20% chance. Oh, and we gotta continue forward. So we can either provide extra rations, being that they just got imprisonment, I think we should probably do that and keep morale as high as we can, because who knows how long it's gonna take to get to the new world. All right, but now we're kind of at a standstill. I'm happy with our population right now. The important part is we're profiting. We are slowly profiting. We don't need a lot of money in the bank, so I'm not trying to do too much just so we don't overexpand ourselves. Now we can build a schooner right now. A schooner, Jesus Christ. But I would really like a frigate. We need one more sail, and it looks like... oh, that's cannons. Oh, God, what's going on now? Oh, God, not again. The seven-year itch. The crew beset by insatiable and painful itching. From lieutenants down to pigeon keepers, they twist and churn in their bunks and cannot sleep. It is affecting their capacity to carry the most basic duties. Something must be done. Find somewhere to stop and get rid of it. Sex chance 15%, analyze the symptoms, the current equipment, so I have no medicine right now, so let's not do that. Let's see if we can maybe find somewhere It's impossible for your aimless navigators to concentrate. Wow, we just lost a lot. Well, can't do much about it. I'm a little worried right now. Moral is pretty low for this early in the journey. But yes, we actually need weapons. I thought it was metal here, but we need the weapon production to do this. So we are earning everything in here, so I guess all we need is a weapon area. So let's do that. That way, hopefully, we can make a frigate before they land in the new world. Oh, people are revolting. This is what I worried about. Okay, so now we officially need police. I probably should have put police down a lot earlier. So it kind of works like fire. Well, they'll just spread their aggression. So hopefully this doesn't last too long. Oh man, I'm gonna have to work on unhappiness. I think that's one thing we could do right now. Try and make these guys a little bit happier. Looks like most people are actually extremely happy though. So schnapps. Okay, we need more schnapps. I mean, schnapps is easy to deal with. So let's throw some schnapps down. The mysterious artifacts. The discovery of several strange artifacts aboard spooks the crew. Tied to the rigging, bunks, boards, and even atop the captain's desk, a warning, a threat. And who put them there? Since the nearby island is uninhabited, it is sensible only to think the perpetrator must be aboard. The crew must know or have seen something last night. Alright, so let's ask the crew. That's all we can really do. A destructive episode. No one has information, or perhaps they withhold it. Oh man, we have low moral right now. We have real low moral. Do we continue? Do we return home? Provide extra rations and continue. Let's just keep going until everyone dies, basically, because I don't got a choice. Worst case, we can build another boat right now. There we go. Oh, what's going on now? All right, let's focus on this, obviously. This is the most important thing. Sea of Sargassum, a ship in need of rescue. The vast floating tapestries of algae in these windless waters have long been thought impassable. Just when you thought your vessel had managed to avoid the yellow-orange plants, you see another ship stuck fast. They must also have seen you as their alarm begins to sound. With no proper rescue equipment aboard, your own ship risks becoming entangled if you get too close. Should you try and help? Oh, God. Guaranteed success. A steamship should have nothing to fear here. Success chance. Harpoon them and tug them away. Don't risk it. I guess we'll try this one. Reward discovered. Okay, so we got a new productivity 20%. So we got some operator that we can use later. Sweet. But I don't have enough cargo space for that. Being that I don't need this right now, I'm just going to confirm this. Offers you a delivery request. I don't got time right now. We need to continue. Oh my god, really? Can you give me a second to place some units, please? Oh god, dude. Okay, hold on. There we go. I just need some workforce, you know? Oh! Did we just... We got it! We found it! This is the new world!
I'm Isabel Sarmento.
Hello, Isabel!
Between me and my country's freedom.
Okay. Do not stand between me. I'm not planning on that. Oh my god, everything is just going on right now. Okay, editor. Here you go. Dude.
We are lucky to have friends to help.
You're gonna offer me a ship already? You're a really nice lady, you know that? Alright, so right now I'm looking for uncharted islands. So we gotta find something right now on this new world. Then we can sail back home. Please tell me this is uncharted. Okay. Oh, yes. Do we got it? Is this? Yes, it's unsettled. Okay. All right, so we're going to move my ship to the old world. So it is going to head back. New expedition. There's so many things going on right now because I'm going so fast. But we are going to, it looks like I can't tab over to my other world. So we got to go to the old world. And we are going to prep my other ship to leave here. Hopefully. This is my ship here. The old Thunderclap. Okay, yes. So we're going to put this in front of here. To move to another region, we're going to the new world. We should, assuming we don't get hit by pirates or be destroyed by anything. Once we get there, we should be able to do this, I think. Holy crap. What's the time right now? We might be able to do this in under an hour. I don't think I missed anything anyways. Hopefully I didn't.
Your ship has returned from its
Okay, my old ship's here. My new ship's gone. This is why I built this ship. There he goes. So it would have took us, you know, all the way to get back there and then to get everything on it to get to the new world. So we saved a little bit of time doing that. Now we should in the new world. Yeah, we have a ship and we can tell it to... Wait, where is it? Okay, so it's right here. So I'm thinking the uncharted island. Yeah, it's right over here. We're good. We just gotta beach it, I think. I've never done this, so kind of learning as we go here, but we should be able to place a trading post once we get close to this, assuming nothing attacks us. And once we do that, That's all we had to do. We had to set foot on the new world. So let's see if we can do that. Build trading post. There we go. Stop the time. 2 hours, 60 minutes. Sorry, we didn't take us 2 hours, 60 minutes, 27 seconds. That's how much time we had left. So we did this in 44 minutes. I really hope that was good enough for the win on this, because I really do want one of you guys to get that PC. As you can see, we can totally build here now, so that's all we had to do. I feel pretty good about this one. I mean, we did screw up just a little bit, but nothing that was too disastrous. We didn't get at a standstill at any time at all, so yeah, here's the new world, guys. All right, guys, and on that, we're gonna wrap up this one here. So like I said, I really hope one of you guys can win that PC. I tried my best. Hopefully it's good enough. We'll have to find out when we find out. But yeah, like I said, if you do want to check out Anno 1800 for yourself, I'll have a link in the description. It is now fully released, so you can go purchase it for yourself. And don't forget, if you do see me in the game, feel free to tweet it out to me, because I still have not seen myself. I know one of you guys have saw me already, and yeah, I'd like to see your tweets, so feel free to do that. And I want to thank once again Ubisoft for sponsoring this video. And thank you guys so much for watching and liking, and I'll see you in the next one.